Even to set it up, think about it and allocate it. Are you going to ask your students to evaluate you? Are you going to do peer evaluation? When you look at what, you know, if you work hard and you came into the school, maybe as an assistant lecturer or as a lecturer at the age of 22, if you work very hard and go and do your masters and do publications and what have you, you arrive to become a chief lecturer at the age of 40. And then you become a chief lecturer, so for the next 25 years, you're a chief lecturer, you have arrived at that position and that status. So you don't feel challenged. Maybe, what else are you looking for? As I said, can there be post-evaluation that if after 3 years you are no longer measuring up, can push you down? Hello? We can push you down from being a chief lecturer to another position, a principal lecturer. Or ask you to go and leave the system. Will you challenge yourselves about such things? The student tyranny, can you introduce a system where you students evaluate themselves anonymously? A student will evaluate another student, that's evaluate themselves anonymously, and then it becomes the system, it is there. And it is technologically driven. So the student is not now saying that you are the one terrorizing him or her, but it can also be seen. And all the lecturers that teach that student will also be evaluating their students. We must begin to interrogate the system. We have many hectares of land in this school. Many hectares of land. There is solar farming. There is biotechnology, biofuel. There's lots of that here too. But you can practically teach your student. You must it always be in the classroom. How much of human experience is introduced in the teaching methodology? We must begin to interrogate the system. Let's not continue to look at leadership and say the country. We can change from where we are, change the system. And you can't let us somebody if you must give what you have. As we were speaking, and they are also working out now, the students, are they challenged enough? As the case lecturer was speaking, we saw a stream of them come out right in front of us. When I was in school and there was something like this and I attended, it means awe. There is a lot of awe that you dare not even make a noise. If you are hard pressed to go and pee, you have to find a way of quietly sleeping, and there is an exit behind. Parents, what are we teaching our children? You know, I wish I can get the names of the students I work now, and I will write a personal letter as chairman of government council to their parents concerning the behavior that they just exhibited. I write a personal letter and ask them to talk to their children, and this is not the way to behave. We must begin to do what? Interrogate the system and tackle our problems. We have a time bomb that's real time bomb waiting. And the day it will blow, all of us will become victims. We must change. And I did it at that. We'll continue. Over the MC, please ask the registrar to come and do in front of us.
This is what I'm coming to Father for you,
the chairman of the Governing Council, yes, His Royal Highness, Director, Deputy Director, Sports and Librarian, Dean's Director, Heads of Departments, Heads of Units, our brother in Bokobali. Here to give the vote of thanks. We start with our chairman. We start with, you don't thank your chairman. You commend him. And, I don't know how to congratulate the chairman for the very successful announcing. It's actually my law. Anywhere, if the chairman is present at any occasion within the Polytechnic, that the minister is not there and the president is not there, it takes automatic precedence. So, in that light, that we are thanking the chairman and also to appreciate his contributions. It was the view of the management that we do a very lowkey convocation ceremony. And on the grand finale, we had 30 minutes for lecture. It was the chairman and his members that said we should separate it, make the lecture to come a day earlier so that it will be truly meaningful. So see your council, see your, the outcome of your work actually. Very nice. Let's appreciate them. We will still come to the spare binder, but we have a royal father present. And it's me here, we represent all the royal fathers. Obofa, Emir of Ilorin, Ilorin, Olubo of Agase, all the crown heads of Kwara State, and indeed Nigeria. And he's our friend. The rector said, when we said, Royal Father, he said, we shouldn't worry, we see Olojoku of Ojoku. He's somebody who is always available. In 2009, we were talking in one place, and we needed the contribution of Prince Afolabi. Somebody knows very well, I like you for long shot. He said, if we call him now, he will start coming from wherever he is. And he actually called him, and he said, guy, within 10 minutes, join us. And that is, how it's always, is, please, let's appreciate him. Let's tell the very shy Olori that we have since overlooked him. We are not inviting her again. We are not even on our behalf. Now I want to appreciate our guest speaker, Professor Abdulrasheed Mahama. We were corrected on council. We said we should not pronounce it. Then this is about to say Nana. That is Nana. Because, it's a spare binder, and we have seen it. And we actually tried for us, he showed the law for the Polytechnic. We gave him short notice, he was outside the country. He said, when is the program? He said, 16. He said, you are coming on the 15th to be able to be here on the 16th. And that he was going to tell his PA to see whether it's this or that. Of course, what you are required to be, and the PA promised us that you make today free, reschedule on other programs for the day. If you get to pass, you will marvel at the beauty of the place. He talked about finance. Maybe he knows or maybe he doesn't know. When he was appointed vice chancellor, and there were many competitors, I asked somebody in government, why are you choosing him? And he now showed me the memo going to the government that of all the people he interviewed, he has the best international exposure, and he has promised the state government that he will be able to
source of funding to get the university going. They actually opened the memo to me that the hospital that people are at Rogu that is Protestant want to congratulate you for living up to your promise and to living up to expectation. And today you are also listening, you are also living up to expectation. And the lecturers, we will still invite you as you are said you are ready to engage them. So thank you very much. The rector, distinguished members of council, congratulations for the very successful outing. And I'm sure you're very proud of us. I'm proud of the Polytechnic. The rector, who is also a member of the council, is the chief of technical of the institution, want to congratulate you, to thank him for his strong support to enable a very successful outing. His parents also present. Unfortunately, we have a snack. He's already a white soldier in rank ahead. But the rector is already a chief lecturer and is a rector. So there's nothing to give the wife or the superior that the spouse of the rector. I want to thank you very much for coming. And the rector introduced her, and she also wrote her name for me, that which one to be addressed, Mrs. Fatima. Thank you. She also came in from US for this program. The deputy rectors, extraordinary human beings. One of them had just got a patent, and we're asking him what's the meaning of the patent. He said, we want to change the oil system from petrol to gas, hydrogen. And you can't carry hydrogen in very large container. A way where he described this on this society, where a very large quantity of hydrogen can compress into a very small container in fueling an aircraft and any other thing of sort. So the letter to him was personally signed by the president, commending for that things. Our senior brother, the deputy rector administration, who is actually on retirement leave, told us that he's going to work to the last day. He was going to fight. That if everybody says he must go, but that God was not ready to fight. We welcome him, and we are an unable person. We appreciate the bursar. Money was available. There wasn't no money for this program. The librarian, we thank you for coming. All the deans and directors here present. One of the DSA, you saw your people, they have been out, the way they came in and the way they left. Please do something about that. The heads of units, once again, we commend and thank our honorable member, Prince Aiko Bola, for compadre, for praising our program. We also have another guest in our midst, Professor Zubari of Unilorin. Then we also appreciate the chairman and members of the organizing committee as well as the sub-committees. We appreciate staff generally, especially those who are present, for being very attentive. The chairman requested for patience and have been duly patient. And the rector said, thank you for that. Please appreciate yourself. Let's speak for all our staff. We are impressed. With you, and although the guest speaker is a spare binder, and the students who are here, the chairman of the three staff unions, two are present, signing and Nasu, asked to permission or gave an apology yesterday that he's traveling today to participate in solving the lingering problem using 30 masks. We also appreciate staff on duty, drivers. When I went outside, I saw the ambulance, and I told people there to please come in. We won't have any crisis. Go and sit down. Go and be part of the world. But they were there, standby. The cleaners, the drivers, decorators, ex service. We all appreciate you, and may God bless everyone who has contributed to the success of this program. We also because I can see some people who are not present, security men, clip clothes, who are seated in the audience, press men. So we thank all of you, and once again I congratulate the chairman, public council members, management, staff, and students. God bless. And we pray and request you to turn up more than this tomorrow. God bless. Please allow me to applause for the registrar. The chairman of council, very distinguished with his engagement. The Olojokuo, who has just endowed the prize award of 25,000 naira to the overall best graduate in this polytechnic. I want to thank you so much, sir. He has done that in Unilore, he has done it in Basu, he has done it in Akima University. So thank you so much, sir, for being it here for us today. That is, sir. Please, I want to remind everyone of us that the convocation grand final and award of prizes and so on and so forth will be taking place tomorrow. Please, we expect all staff to be seated by 9 o'clock. The program will kick off yesterday, 10 o'clock, 10 a.m. at the indoor sports hall. 10 a.m. tomorrow, please. Then on Friday, the human service for appreciating what God has done for this vision of the 10th convocation will be holding in the main campus, not mini campus, just like that. Then on Sunday, human service at the chapel of grace at the main. Thanksgiving, prayer. Sorry. I'm a Christian. I'm Sunday, I'm surrounding you. So the Thanksgiving service will be holding at the Chapel of Grace at the mini campus. 10 a.m. on Sunday. Please let me pray. Thank you so much. Immediately after the national anthem, we will have the group photograph just in front of this one-person auditorium. I want to now request the family to please come and give us a closing prayer. Dr. Saman, the head of the panel of computer science, and Mrs. Mary Olowe, the dean quality assurance. Dr. Saman.
We thank God for our yesterday, we thank God for today, we want to be seeing, to continue to be our God for tomorrow. We want to appreciate our guest lecturer, the Royal Father, and all our guests. We are wishing you very mercy back to the expected definition. We are only praying for the council, management, the deans, the HODs, and all our staff, the students. Rabbana Allah to say, we go by number that is a bit of our Abla and Abila to Paramata in the Panta Baha. Rabbana Allah to say, we do ya, Sabata, wa bilaya, wa ta, Sabata, wa kita, Sabata, Subhan, or pick a rabbi is that you have a school. Hassala, wa la musadi, wa la hamdan in lahi, wa la bilaya. Thank you.
Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, our dear Most High God, we just want to appreciate you for all the wonderful things that you have been doing since the inception of this program. Lord, we are exalted in Jesus' name. We thank you for the lives of all that are here today. We thank you for the daily lessons that you have given to be here. Lord, we say this is bottom and glory in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, and our God, most especially for the guest speaker that you have used for us today. Lord, we pray that you increase his knowledge in the name of Jesus. And we commit tomorrow's program into your hands. As you have made today a success unto us, we pray you pray for us again tomorrow in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. We appreciate you. In Jesus' powerful name, we are praying.
Amen. The General Council, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this is why we call it today on this 10th Convocation Lecture as we rise for the National Anthem. National Anthem, please. Director, this procession starts by 9:30 a.m. tomorrow. Procession starts. Please follow me. Please give another room or zero. Let the